Welcome to the morning of a vlog. It's probably in the mid-40s now. Flew back yesterday from Copenhagen, just got up. Well, I say just got up about just after 8, had about 9 hours sleep, something like that. Just getting some morning hydration, 500 ml of water. Then just going to take Bruce on the field for a run. Then you go to the gym and train legs. Going to have a pre-workout meal en route to the gym. But yeah, feels good to be back. Feels good to be home. Living it. But yeah, I'm literally just halfway through doing my morning exercise and I thought, oh, best to do. Open the vlog. But yeah, I'll get a little bit of footage at the gym doing legs. And it's also my niece's birthday today. So I don't know what I'm going to give you, but yeah, legs today. Let's get it. Yes, sir. Taking Bruce out. Late for the gym. Esty's gonna be buzzing. But yeah, definitely feeling relaxed after a week. Basically a week off, sort of thing. Well, I trained once, I did 2 work days, but basically a week off. We'll call it that for simplicity's sake. I definitely feel more relaxed today. 9 hours sleep last night, not playing games. Can't believe the first night we got there, I slept for 10 hours straight without even waking up to go to the toilet. So, that's a sign that your body needs rest. But yeah, feeling good, heading into training the legs now. I'm gonna follow the same routine pretty much that I did prior to going away. And I've got it in my head that I want to go train at a fucking... I want to go train somewhere where they've got a seated leg curl, because Maloney's gym, great gym, but they just don't have a seated leg curl. And I want to go somewhere with a leg extension where it's just like straight up and down. The one at Maloney's, even though it's a fantastic gym, the fucking leg extension, it forces, because of the way it's built, it forces your legs to kind of go out to the side. It just doesn't feel right. Obviously seated ham curl and the leg extension, like the mainstay in, it's like both great movements that you want in your plan really. But I just figured fuck it, we'll just smash the standing ham, smash the laying ham. Tempted today, if my back feels up to it, to smash some dumbbell RDLs, pause at the bottom just to limit load. But yeah, other than that, I'm going to be pushing the pendulum squat. That's definitely one that feels good to me. And I might do some back squats again. I'm actually tempted, believe it or not. I've been doing like a high bar back squat because you get more knee flexion. So your knees basically works your quads more. Believe it or not, I've seen a man like Sam Sulik doing like a low bar squat but with a heel elevated. So it's kind of like, why don't you just do fucking high bar, bro? But obviously, he'll have the heel elevation because he's might have just limited ankle range of motion, or he just wants to get as much knee flexion as possible, but he might find that he can just lift more weight, I don't know, with a low bar. But it looks like something that probably be quite comfortable to me. And end of day, no matter how good something is on paper, or how bad something is on paper sometimes as well, like if it feels good and you can progress it and you get stronger on it and your physique is changing and you can train everything else how you're supposed to, then it's not necessarily a bad movement for you. So I might give that a go. I am half tempted. I quite like his approach, how he kind of just does like not many exercises, and he just sort of just does more work on them exercises. So it's like, instead of doing 2 hard sets to failure on like a hack and then 2 hard sets to failure on a leg press, he'll just send the squat. I like how simple that is. Now, you know, is it optimal? No. You know, you're missing out. You're probably going to get a more lengthened quad on something like a hack squat. And then you're probably going to get more hip work and, you know, you're probably just going to get like a slightly different sort of stimulus on your quads in a leg press, maybe. Definitely get more like glute and hip work on a leg press. But I suppose it's like one of them, like, I think we can overthink it. You know, trying to make everything perfect on paper does it end up being perfect in practicality? Whereas like that man's just like, right, I'm gonna send this, I'm sending it on fucking seated leg curl. He's gonna do like 7 sets of seated leg curl to failure. Sent it on that, his hamstrings are gonna get hit. Sent it on squats, his quads, adductors, glutes are getting hit. That's pretty much all your muscularity at your legs. Do you know what I mean? It's just like, yeah, so fucking simple, man. Not trying to overcomplicate it, just doing his own thing. So I can't quite like that. So I might take some inspiration from that guy, which I never thought I'd say, but then after watching him, I thought this guy's pretty cool. He just knows his own, he's sort of just like learning his own body stuff. Well, he knows his own body really well for somebody who's only 21 years old. Fucking, and he's obviously the beast. Enhanced monster. Pretty, he's got some pretty good shit. So yeah, anyway, pre-workout meal, 100 grams of oats, 60 grams of whey, 50 grams of frozen raspberries, and then we've got a coffee out of the machine. It's only decaf though, so man's not coming in caffeinated today, just because he just wants a coffee basically. But yeah, I'm going to bounce because I'm going to be there anytime now, and I'm already late, so I need to make sure I get this food in me. See ya.
So it's third movement, just going plain leg curl, 4 sets, and double leg extension, 3 sets down the leg press. Then I'm going to go pendulum to rotate that bad boy. Then I'm going to do one more hamstring hinge sort of thing. So we might do like a dumbbell RDL or something like that, I'll get the extension. Then one more ham curl, and then
as you can see, Sam has got the safeties on.
Standardised range. It's actually not that
shallow of a rep when you do them.
So yeah, safety first.
Right, legs have been smoked. Yeah, I'm definitely gonna keep up with like additional calf work over the week, because when you do get to them at the end of the session, they are, you know, you're just fucked, man. And time of the essence as well. It's not, I'm not at university anymore, fucking dossing a degree with no Mrs. Baby plans really, other than just going to get pissed or something. So yeah, good session overall. We started off with laying hamstring curl, did 4 sets on there, then did leg extension, 3 sets, more sets on the hamstring curl, just because we're not directly targeting this hamstring on any of the squat patterns, leg presses, anything like that, so the quads are just getting obliterated regardless in a leg day. So we did laying hamstring, 4 sets, then we did what you'd consider 7 hard work sets for quads. So we did 3 sets of leg extension, 2 sets of like a narrow low foot placement leg press, so more quad, and then a pendulum squat as well. So we did, you know, 7 total sets of quads there. So 4 hamstring at the beginning, then 7 quad. Then we did 3 more sets of hamstring, maybe 4, So we did like 7 or 8 sets of hamstring, 7 sets of quads, and then we just finished with seated calf raise, and we just did 3 sets of that. I felt a pump from my very first set of that. I felt a pump, fucking like pump and burn, fucking straight away. Like, no fucking calf, even though I got tiny calf, I got pumped to fuck after the first set. So keeping that one in for a bit, literally just focused on tensing my calf as hard as I can, and then controlling back down rather than just fucking launching it about. I think long term it's just going to be better for joint health doing it that way. Plus I felt like I got a good return on it, but we'll see. In a year's time, if I've developed any sort of calf, we'll know if I've got a good return on it. So yeah, that was today's leg session. Not super high volume, overall pretty decent. Got in there for about 20 to 10, 9:40, and then got out of there at 10 past 11. So what's that, like an hour and a half?
Yeah, hour and a half leg session.
I think much longer my attention span fucking... I used to not struggle with attention span when training at all. I used to be able to just fucking stay it, but I think training like a bodybuilder, like, I do find it difficult to keep my attention span if I'm in there for much over an hour and a half now. So yeah, nice short session. Going to be sprinkling in some additional calves later in the week, because I've done 3 sets today. I want to get at least 10 sets total done on calves in the week, probably closer to 15 as it is a weak body part. And then I also might add in some additional hamstrings as well. So the overall workload is in the leg department is favoured towards hams and calves, as I feel like quads look pretty decent. I mean, they're not massive up at the, like, I still need to get them better, but in comparison, like, I've got no calf whatsoever. And hamstrings fucking lagging as well, so that's what we're gonna do with leg development. I'm just gonna head home now, gonna have post-workout meal, because shit just got real. Chicken and rice. You don't have to have chicken and rice, by the way, it's just what I have. It's on my meal plan. I like to just stick to a meal plan, it's easy, I don't have to think. Sometimes if I really didn't fancy chicken and rice, I'd just swap the macros. The macros is like the macros, and then obviously making sure your digestion's good. That's like your most important stuff. Obviously you want to get some micronutrients in there. So macros being proteins, fats and carbs. So like, for example, if I wanted to have like whey protein powder again and cream of rice after a train, or even whey in cereals. I know Tom doesn't like having loads of fucking sugars in there. I don't think it's necessarily an issue. Post-workout, I don't think it's an issue, to be fair. Post-workout, having a bit. But yeah, like if you have 80 grams of carbs and 80 grams of carbs from Cocoa Pops or fucking cream or ice or pasta or whatever you fancied, and then, you know, 40 grams of protein from whatever protein source you fancy, whether chicken or, you know, whey. You know, not something high fat. You don't want to be having like a fatty red meat. You don't want to be having eggs post workout, because it's going to slow down digestion a bit, and that's not what you want after you train. You want it to digest relatively fast. But yeah, don't sweat it. Don't have to be chicken and rice, is what I'm trying to say. You can basically have whatever you want within reason, and that's going to help you stick to it long term. It's, you know, life's for enjoying as well as smoking your goals, so why not do both if you can? But yeah, that's legs done. I've got cardio to do, 300 calories on the bike at some point today. So I'll probably do it tonight, to be honest, if I'm being honest. We've got little C's birthday party at 1 o'clock. So I've got to leave for that in just over an hour. So I don't have time to go. I don't have time to do it now, because I need to go back and cook food. But yeah, I'll probably do it tonight after we get back from little C's birthday. And then that'll be it, really. Just train the day nutrition plan, straight back on it. It's a lovely day. I feel like I want to get outside, but for the remainder of the day, we'll be inside, but that's okay, because it's for little C's birthday. And then tomorrow, hopefully, we've got the same type of weather, and then I can get out with Florence, probably get on a canal walk or something, because that would be delicious. I'm just focusing on driving. If you're wondering why I'm not talking, man cannot do 2 things really well at once. other than enjoy his life and hit his fucking fitness goals, aka Cocoa Pops, and getting jacked. Right, I'm off. I'm just talking shit now. No value has been added in this conversation. I shall see you soon.
So obviously it doesn't look like anything special because it's not. Chicken, rice, light and light mayonnaise, and the exact same thing post-workout with a banana. At Little C's birthday, I had a hot beef sandwich, 1.5 roast potatoes. What else came with it? And some 5% chilli that Emma always makes, which was lovely. But yeah, this is now meal number, properly meal number 3. Call it 3.5, because it's a bit of a snack that we had there. Going to have a meal with Penny tonight. I'm going to do Caesar, chicken Caesar salad. Going to have a garlic bread and that. Might even have a dessert. We're definitely having a dessert. And then tomorrow, just back on full planaruna. God, this has been the craziest, most inconsistent nutrition-wise I've had since 2022. And it's now, obviously, 2024. That's just what it's been like these last few weeks. Christmas, holiday, all that jazz. But yeah, this is my off-plan meal of the week, even though I just had a fucking off week, sort of thing. And then, yeah, tomorrow, back on full plan, giving it some. But definitely feel better today for just eating and training and sleeping better, how I should do. But yeah, I think the biggest benefit, lessons take away, this goes to anyone that's not just like smashing your gym stuff, but like family, business, work, and you're going hard, and you're trying to push and be more for you and your family and stuff, or just even just for yourself. I think breaks every now and again definitely serve the purpose, or they do for me anyway. Like, I feel so relaxed. And I know I've got loads of stuff coming up this week, like calls with people, you know, there's things that I want to go well that are outside, you know, somewhat in my control. I can influence them, but you know, they might not go well, and that's the realities of like week to week stuff. But having this week off definitely made me, I just definitely feel just like just more relaxed in general going into that normal working week where there is pressure and things. So yeah, definitely recommend a break. You don't have to be anything fancy. You don't have to go to Dubai or Copenhagen or anything like that. You could just have a week just where you just relax and go for walks and stuff. So yeah, rest is good. And eat this, I'll show you the off-plan meal tonight, and then I'll fit my cardio in at some point as well. Let's get it.
Lisa.
Good boy.